So good morning, children.
In last two videos, I would say we talked about six different rights given by the government of India under the Constitution of India. Okay, but now with the rights, with your birth, you have some rights like that. With your birth, you have some sort of fundamental duties. Fundamental duties are called to be the basic duties, which is granted by the Constitution of India. That means if you are the citizen of India, if you live in this country, in that case you have some certain duties towards your nation, you have some certain responsibilities towards your nations, and you are ought to follow those responsibilities. Okay, that is called fundamental duties. The people of India were more aware of their rights, as I said. No, we are more bothered aware about rights. We are least bothered about our duties. Just as the citizens are given various fundamental rights, various fundamental duties are incorporated by the Constitution of India, that is an amendment changed into the 1976. Fundamental duties aims to inculcate love for the nation, national integrity, various high ideals and value awareness among the citizen, thereby helping in developing the nation. Every citizen of India should contribute toward the protection of the national unity, integrity and sovereignty, so that they remain full peace and security. Communal harmony, that is religious harmony, can be accorded. The fundamental duties according to the textbooks and into the constitutions are mentioned below. To abide by the constitution and respect its ideal and institutions, the national flag and national anthem. Okay, so we must respect our national anthem, we must respect our national flag. Every time I say we develop this national feeling twice in a year, that is only on 26th of January and 15th of August. These were the 2 days when we hold the national flag in our hand. Okay, and in the next day you will find the same national flag into the dump, into the garbage. So my dear, this is the insult of your nation, this is the insult of your own self. And so that I would rather strictly prohibited any goods, any article, any cloth which has a national flag. Now sometimes we all love kite flying, and in kite flying also we have some certain kites with the national flag. But do you imagine, my dear children, that once you fly the kite and once it is cut, where will it go? It will go to some dump, it will go to some garbage. So that is the insult of your nation. That should not be practiced. I would wish, my dear children, that you do not buy any good, any article, any cloth which has a national flag. Because when you do this, one day it comes that it goes to dump. Okay? So stop this practice. Nowadays we wear mask. No, due to this COVID-19, I observed that so many people were putting this mask on their face on this 15th of August. So this is a very wrong practice, because they are using this and then they throw into dump. So you yourself is insulting your nation, then what you can expect from other citizens, other country people? To cherish and follow the noble ideas which inspired our nations and struggle for freedom, to uphold and to protect the sovereignty, unity and integrity of our nation, to defend the country and to provide national services as and when required. Okay? To promote the harmony and the spirit of the common brotherhood amongst all the people of India, transcending religious, linguistic and regional or sectional diversities, to renounce the practices derogatory to the dignity of woman, correct, to value and preserve the rich heritage of our composite culture. No, like I take an example of this national heritage, Champaner. It is been declared national heritage by UNESCO. Okay,
our president, late APJ Abdul Kalam Abul Fakir, Jaluddin Abdul Kalam had come for the, what do we call, felicitation of that place. But what do people do there? People go there, they visit there, they carry the polythene bag with them, they carry some sort of nasta in there, and they enjoy over there, and they dump everything over there, and they come there. So that is not the right approach. My dear children, it is your and my duty to care, to protect, and to maintain the dignity of such places. I have seen so many people, they write their names over there on these monuments. This is not done, my dear children. It's our duty to protect it. It's our duty to maintain its dignity. Okay? So it is very tender. It is to be very soft-spoken and very softly touched. So it should not be harmed by any means. Then, to protect and improve the natural environment, including forest, lake, rivers, wildlife, and to have a compassion for living creatures.
इससे मुझे याद आया, what is the human tendency? You, for example, you are going to Kamati Bagh, okay? So in Kamati Bagh, you are taking a round to the flower garden, and there a bird is kept, do not pluck the flower. So what is our human tendency? No, if it is mentioned that do not pluck the flower, so our very first job is to pluck the flower. Isn't it, my dear children? So we need to improve this. We have to learn this. We have to have a compassion for the living creature, either it is the animal, or either it is bird, or either it is anything else. See, dog is taken for the granted. No, like if you are moving somewhere, or if you are in your street and suddenly the dog come, it is very apparent that you will start, you will ask him to move away. Such gestures naturally comes in your mouth. Let us have compassion for such animals. Let us have a compassion for any animal. Why should we treat them like that? Okay, they actually don't deserve it. So we must have a compassion for creatures, for flowers, for plants, you know, for everybody. To develop the scientific temper, humanism, and the spirits of inquiry and reform. To safeguard the public property, as I said, and abjure to leave the violence. To strive towards the excellence in all sphere of India, individual and collective activity, so that the nation rises to higher level and endeavor and achieve the achievement. Who is a parent or the guardian to provide opportunities for education to his child, or as the case may be, ward between the age of the 6 and 14 years. 6th January, underline my dear children, is being celebrated as every year as a fundamental duty day. All these duties, some duties are backed by the law. The person violating it cannot be sentenced, cannot be punished here. A sentence meaning a teacher should make efforts so that the students follow the duties and they become aware about it. It is our duty and responsibility as a citizen to see that the various social evils and custom prevailing in the society should be removed, like untouchability, drudgery, child labor, woman exploitation, dowry, female forticide. You know, children, female forticide. Female forticide, I just make you understand a very simple term. In earlier beginning of the 19th century, the birth of the female child was called to be unholy. Okay? Because woman was considered to be the burdensome. She was not imparted education. And you see that all the norms, all the rules which were made, they were made for women only. That they had to cover their head, that they have to eat only plate after the husband eats, that she cannot impart education, that she cannot go out of four wall. That means all the rules and regulations were made for women. And it was that century where the birth of the woman child was called to be unholy. And as a result of that, what they used to do? दे यूज टू ड्राउन द फीमेल बेबी इन द मिल्क. छोटी बच्ची को पैदा होते ही दूध के बर्तन में रख देते थे. सो शी विल ड्रिंक द मिल्क एंड शी विल डाई. ओके, सो इट वॉज कॉल्ड फीमेल फॉर्टिसाइड, फीमेल इन्फेंटिसाइड. इल कस्टम, सुपरस्टिशंस एक्सेट्रा. दिस ड्यूटीज आर डायरेक्टिव इन द कन्वेइंग अस दैट वॉट अ सेंसिबल एंड अवर सिटीजन मस्ट डू. ओके, यू एंड आई आर सेंसिबल एंड अवर सिटीजन्स, एंड इवन आफ्टर रीडिंग दिस, इफ वी कंटिन्यू डूइंग दिस और इफ यू फाइंड दैट दिस आर बींग प्रैक्टाइज समवेयर एंड इफ वी कीप अवर माउथ शट, देन वी आर नॉट जस्टिफाइंग अवर ड्यूटी. If citizens propagate the importance and utilization of fundamental duties, these future citizens develop the feeling of the national responsibility, international brotherhood, and just an exploitation-free society. So, my dear children, these are the fundamental duties which are guaranteed by the Constitution of India. Being the citizen of India, being the responsible citizen of India, being the sensible citizen of India, it is your and my duty to follow it. It's your and my duty to implement it. It's your and my duty to see that there is no exploitation of anybody and we have a compassion for every living being on this earth. Okay, my dear children, so tomorrow we will talk about this directive principle of the state policy and we will complete the lesson as a part of your homework. My dear children, you will be writing the short note about what do we call the fundamental duties granted by the Constitution of India. Okay, children, see you then. Take care. Bye-bye.